Once I have a map of my equipotential lines, I can also find the electric field. So I'm going to unplug the two banana plugs and replace it with a dual banana plug. That has the advantage of having two probes at a set distance. One of them is marked with a ground tab. It says GND. I want to put that in the black side on low, and then that side I want to keep track there. I'm now measuring a potential difference between those two points. So if I measure there, I'd get 0.9 volts. If I measure there, I'd get 1.0 volts. If I measure up here, I get 2.2 volts. We're going to step through the greatest change in potential. So I'll start near one of my electrodes and I'll move, keep that point fixed, move the other end around until I find the largest change in electrical potential for that set distance between those two points. So that looks like about there. So I would mark, oh, my largest change in potential goes from that point to that point. And then I'd pick it up and put the same end, or the flagged end, down at that place where I found the biggest change. And then I'd look again, keeping one side fixed, moving the other side, looking for the largest change in electrical potential for that fixed distance. And ah, that's my largest change. And then I would do it again, sweeping around until I find the largest change. And I can track that all the way from one electrode to the other electrode. And I want to get about seven lines going, stepping along, finding that largest change, so that everybody in the group has a chance to get a line.